do some zooming to it. It's on the front there, on the front of the eyepiece. See the button there, the big flat one? The top one's to bring it out, and the front, the bottom one's to bring it in. Bring it in.
Thank you. very much. Okay, anybody else have questions? On the road? Yeah, last year I started with Alice Cooper. I played like 3 months on his tour. And then my record came out and I went out with my own band. We played some clubs for a while. And then in December we went out for a month with Rush, opening act for those guys. And then we went back out this year and did like 5 more months of clubs.
When you like write your songs, do you like the drummer and the guys make their own stuff up around what you play?
What I do is I write the songs and I demo them, so everything's on tape, and then I give the tapes to the bass player and the drummer, and they kind of learn the stuff, and then they put their own little licks and stuff in there, because, you know, I like to interact with the other musicians. I don't like to write everything out and say, here, play this. I'd rather give them the tape and say, learn it, and, do your own thing. Do I write lyrics? Yeah. I don't sing, though. How do I judge whose voice?
By Satriani's boy.
And by?
Yeah.
Oh, they're both great.
Friedman Baker.
I haven't really heard much of that, but.
Oh dear. You're right?
I think guitar playing in general sucks. No. I like to check things out, but I don't really listen to a lot of instrumental stuff too much because it's what I do, and I would probably totally burn out on it if I listened to it also.
You have another guitarist when you want to run that?
No, it was 3-piece. I'm just bass, drums, and guitar the way God created rock and roll. And, you know, I had a really good drummer and bass player, so they really could fill in a lot of space. I tried to get down here really bad with my band into a tour, but it just didn't work out, so hopefully we'll be able to do it next time. Hey, what kind of pizza you got there? Did you ever see Fast Times at Richmond High? Because I was thinking, since this is our time, and it's our pizza, so hand it out to these guys. Mr. Hand. Well, Joe Franco is actually a real rock player, definitely. I think it was the songs themselves that were kind of more fusion-y than stuff I had done in the past.
Yeah, that's the one
he wants
to hear. That one
to
hear rock and roll.
Jeez. I don't really remember any of that stuff. To go on the road with. I rented my own tour bus so I didn't have to be on the same bus with him because I was afraid he would kill me or chop my head off overnight. No, he's a really cool guy actually. But the snakes, gotta stay away from the snakes. As soon as he picked the snake up on stage, I was out of there. Yeah, but he's a pretty cool guy. Oh, yeah. My favorite players, Johnny Diesel, Ian Ross, Jack Jones, Tommy Emmanuel, Harvey James, Kevin Borick, and Slim Dusty. See that? I'm hip. Kind of bagged it for a while, and I'm just for some reason coming around and doing it again. Basically, I get sick of things, and then I kind of get sick of them, and then I don't do them for a while. So I figure the more I play, the more things I'll get sick of, and I won't play anymore, and pretty soon I'll just have to get quit guitar, because there'll be nothing left.
What do you think of Alvin Lee?
Opinions off him? Alvin Lee? I think he was great. Yeah, I like that stuff. Yeah. I like that song, and I'd love to change the world. He totally rips in that. Harvey James, how about a big hand? Now, I know this guy rips, because I've heard him.
Isn't it funny, you play with Roadrunner, all the sport records and that? Did you, take into relativity in that, or is each of them got an influence with you in that on a different level?
What is the question? I heard it, but I just didn't understand. Yes, and no.
Midnight Barney, did he follow you to Relativity Records? That's what
it's... No, I was on Barney's label for my first record, and then I left his label and went with Polygram for the second, and the third is on Relativity Records, which is Sony Worldwide. Way in the back.
Everyone just got sliding for a couple of reasons.
All right. Anything in particular you want to hear? Cups of coffee before you go on.
Scales you mainly using?
What scales am I mainly using?
All seven modes or just...
Yeah, I like to mix it up. You know, really the song structure, the chords in the song determine what scales and what modes you're going to play. You know, I have a particular, a couple that I like a lot, like just basic major, minor, mixolydian I like a whole lot.
You mostly over more minor stuff though, or
mostly what?
Minor scales now.
Minor scales sometimes. It really, again, it depends on the song. Mixolydian is more major sounding. I like that a lot.
Did you write the rich person? Because of that change,
actually, Meltdown, I wrote songs more the rhythms first, actually. I would just kind of be sitting around and come up with a rhythm type of thing. And then I would just write a riff over top of it. So it came more from a rhythmical type of thing. I really started getting into playing more swing type of stuff. Most of the solos, when I do the demo of all the tunes before I go in the studio, I do the solos there first. And if I like them, I'll copy them on the record. I'll do them on the record, like the demo. So I go in the studio, half of them are improvised in the studio, and half of them are kind of copied from the demo, which were initially improvised anyway. And then when I go out and play live shows, it's kind of the same thing. Some songs I'll play solos just like the record, and sometimes I'll just kind of improvise.
What type of band feel
would you be looking
for? What type of
what? Band feel? It's got to be pretty heavy, definitely. Like a real good singer. More of a bluesier Paul Rogers type of singer with a big voice. Do you know him? Yeah, I mean, I'm always going to do solo records also, and hopefully the next one will actually be a combination of like a bunch of instrumental songs and maybe some vocal stuff, and then the band record after that. It all depends on when I find a singer. It's kind of hard to get one.
Yeah, Mike, you want to get here and get Ed, or you want to play some drama?
I spend a lot of time on the demos at home, so when we go into the studio, we've already rehearsed the tunes, they're totally finished, and we just kind of go in there and lay it down. Now, sometimes you need time to like experiment, definitely, so we don't rush through it, we take our time, but I like to get in there and get it done. I don't want to spend like 3 years making a record. Am I a keyboard fan? And what? Well, on the first two records I had keyboards, and on the third one I didn't. It was like Spinal Tap. Instead of the drummer dying, the keyboard players are all dying. I had about six of them in the last year, and they all died, so no more keyboards. All right, this song's called Check It Out.
Thank you.
Okay, are there any last questions?
Yeah, who's your favorite three-piece trio?
My favorite three-piece trio? Probably like Hendrix, Cream.
Okay. Rush!
Rush is really great. Who else am I forgetting? No?
Friday.
Who?
Friday.
They're four-piece though.
Troy,
yeah, they were great too. Hey, let's see how many three-piece bands we can name in an hour. Wait, somebody get out a piece of paper and a pen. Okay, Creed, Hendrix. How about Crosby, Stills, and Nash?
ZZ Top.
ZZ Top, there's
Double
another
Trouble.
One.
Double Trouble.
Double Trouble, all right.
Jackson.
Steve, come on.
Jackson.
The Beatles, if they reform.
Led Zeppelin, if they reform. Go ahead, make dad jokes. What? Can I play what? I don't really know. Well, actually I did Foxy Lady live with my band, but I don't really sing and there's no band. What can I do but go? Do I know any of his licks? No, sorry. I like some things. In general, I'm not really into the thrash thing, but I think like Metallica's new record is incredible. But I'm not really into the real heavy shit.
What are you talking about?
Actually, when we do the Vinnie Ward model, like the signature thing, one of the small changes is that it's going to be a Strat type of plate, so the board goes in there. What do I think of them? It's pretty good. I don't know. I've always liked 22 fret guitars, and I'm just kind of used to them. I just like them. 22's enough. 24, and I'd be lost. It's just two more. Because these go up to 22. A little bit, but no. I mean, I use regular fretboards with really high frets. Dunlop 6105s. I'm sorry, what was that?
77 on the Panzer.
77, I was just starting to play guitar. And then like a year later, Van Halen 1 came out, and I'm Frank Marino on Mahogany Rush Live. Totally changed my life. Live, I go through a crybaby, and then into my wireless unit, which is a Rexer, and right into the head, and then through the effects loop, I have a Rocktron Hush 2 unit, and then a Boss Delay, Boss Flanger, and Boss Chorus. It's pretty simple, just like three pedals on the floor of a wah-wah. Everybody laughs at it that sees it, because everybody's got these big refrigerator racks full of shit. But I've never really been into that.
You're one of. Who is the best, and who's your favorite guitarist?
Who is the best? Where's that list? I don't think there's any best, because there's been so many great players. You know, it's really hard to say who's the best.
Who's your favorite?
Remember that list of people I named? No, I mean Hendrix, Van Halen, Schrauer, Frank Marino. Well, Hendrix, Van Halen, and Jimmy Page. Blackmore too. See, I can't like narrow it down. I just keep that. Oh wow, Blackmore. I wrote that. Normally the melody's in the song, but it's always a song because they're kind of in that really hard tune. But in the solos, you know, a lot of times I'll just improvise stuff, and sometimes I'll play a solo like the record. And you know, live we would break things down dynamically and do a pattern and stuff. And when we did the new record, we recorded bass and drums together, and I played along with the band. And I wanted to keep guitar parts also, but everything I played sucked. Oh no, but my amp blew up, so I was playing through something else, and it didn't really sound good. So I was playing along with the kept bass.
Thank you. Love you.
Just guitar and the radio. For making demos, like guitar-oriented demos, just write as much stuff as you possibly can. Guitars and things, and also the Fender for having me here. How about a big hand for Fender? Thank you very much.
I think.